हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू वर्ड शार्ड।
सो टुडे वील बी टॉकिंग अबाउट माई ग्रेटेस्ट ओलंपिक प्राइज विच इज रिटन बाई जेसी ऑविंस। हु इज जेसी ऑविंस? ही इज अ सन ऑफ अ शेयर क्रॉपर एंड ग्रैंड सन ऑफ अ स्लेव। सो दिस टेल्स यू डिरेक्टली दैट ही वॉज फ्रॉम अ वेरी मे बी समवॉट ऑफ अ पुअर फैमिली एंड नो ओलंपियन बिफोर हिम हैड अकम्प्लिश्ड something which he accomplishes. So he is successful in something which many people are not successful in the Olympic Games. So we will come to know what Jesse Owens does. When does he do all this? He won 4 gold medals in 1936 Olympic Games in Berlin. Where is Berlin? Berlin is the capital of Germany. Had made him the best remembered athlete in Olympic history. So he is a very renowned name in Olympic history because he won 4 gold medals in the 1936 Olympic Games. Where was it held? It was held in Berlin. Now, other than all this information, we will also come to know the most important part of story is this one, is he grows a beautiful friendship with another athlete, and we will come to know about that in the story. Okay, let's move to the story and we will get an idea of the whole thing. My greatest Olympic prize, written by Jesse Owens. Before we move into the detail, let us come to know what is Olympic Games. Olympic Games is a type of a game where different countries play together, different kinds of games. There can be broad jump, there can be long jump, there can be races and various kinds of games. Okay. So all these green colored ones, all those places which are marked green, they were already participating in the Olympic Games then. Okay. And all those places which are marked blue in color, these places are the ones who had started playing the Olympic Games from the year 1936. So over here, Jesse Owens was from North America. He was a native of North America. He was a Negro. And where is Germany? Germany is here. And Berlin is also here. It is the capital of Germany. So this man, Jesse Owens, has come so far from here to here, okay, to Germany, to Berlin, to play the Olympic Games. And he obviously wants to win it. Okay. Jesse Owens, now this is the true story. So I will let you know the incidents that happened, as well as what are the places where he enrolled his name, what are the games he enrolled himself with. So it was the 100 and the 200 meter dashes, that is, he participated in the 100-200 meters run. Broad jump, what is broad jump? It is same as the long jump. And the 400 meter relay, what is the relay race? Relay race, you often have participated in your school games. It is a kind of race where 3 or 4 members act as a group. Okay, there may be 4 houses and each house has 4 members divided into groups. Now, these groups play together. There is a task given. Maybe you have to reach a particular place, but 4 of you will work together to carry out that task. That is relay race. So that's all. And this, we will also talk about Luz Long. He's another character over here. I already told that there is another athlete who will be very important, a significant character in this story. So Luz Long is that person. He dies, he's killed in Sicily. Where is Sicily? Sicily is the largest island in the Mediterranean Sea. So during the World War II, our character, this character Luz Long, he's a real character. So he dies. Now let's read the story. This is a true story. It was the summer of 1936. It is previously said that it was the Olympic Games going on, 1936, in Berlin. Olympic Games were being held in Berlin. All the meanings are given. You can write it down in your copies. Capital of Germany. Because Adolf Hitler childishly insisted that his performers, that means the German performers, were members of a master race, nationalistic feelings were at an all-time high. Now, Adolf Hitler was trying to build up a nationalistic feeling, a feeling that, yes, I am a German and I am a superior class. I am better than the rest of the people in the world. Okay, and all the people other than the Germans are not high quality, or they are not as good as us. They are the inferior beings, not superior as Germans. So this was a belief of Hitler, and many people in Germany used to hold the same belief. So there were participants from Germany also. Now, I wasn't too worried about all this. Who is I? This one is Jesse Evans. He was not much worried about Hitler's ideas and philosophies. I had trained. Why he was not bothered about that? Because he had trained himself well. He had sweated. He had practiced a lot and disciplined himself for 6 years. For 6 long years, he had been practicing constantly so that he could participate and score well in the Olympic Games. With the games in the mind, I always had this games, that is the Olympic Games. I always practiced more and more because I had a feeling that I obviously have to win the Olympic Games. While I was going over on the boat means while I showed you in the map all that, he had to cross the water body so far away. So while he was in the ship, all I could think about was taking home one or two of those gold medals. So I always had a desire that I will obviously win one or two medals in the Olympic Games. I had my eye specially on the running broad jump. So I always had one desire that in broad jump, that is in long jump, I will surely win, because that was what I was very good at. A year before, as a sophomore, what is a sophomore? Meaning is given here, second year high school student. When I was a second year high school student at the Ohio State University, I had set the world's record of 26 feet 8 and 1/4 inches. So already he had set a world record when he was a student. Okay, when he was a second year high school student, he had already scored the world's record, that is 26 feet and 8 1/4 inches. So it was quite huge. He had already done his work. He was already the world's record setter. So he was sure that he is going to win. Everyone kind of expected me to win that Olympic event hands down. What do you mean by hands down? Hands down means that he's surely going to win. Everybody knew that this Jesse Owens is surely going to win the at least the long jump medal. I was in for a surprise, but when I went there and when I opted for the the game, then I was a bit surprised. When the time came for the broad jump trials, what do you mean by trials? Before you are jumping for the final round, you have to jump for the trials also. Before the final round, there is a trial jump also. You are given 3 chances, okay, a total of 3 chances in the trials. If you can qualify in any one of these 3 jumps, then you are qualified for the finals. But if you foul in all the 3 cases, in all the 3 trials, then you are disqualified for the game. Okay, then you cannot play for the finals. Obviously, you have to jump, you have to qualify yourself at least in one jump in the trials. Okay, I was startled, I was shocked to see a tall boy hitting the pit at almost 26 feet on his practice leaps. So even in the practice leaps, while he was practicing, he found that there was a boy who was quite tall, and that boy was quite good at long jump. He was doing 26 feet. He was jumping 26 feet on his practice leaps. And what was his score? His score was 26 feet, 8 1/4 inches. So the difference was only 8 1/4 inches. He turned out to be a German named Laszlong. Who is this person who was jumping so well? He was the German named Laszlong. I was told that Hitler had kept him under wraps. What do you mean by under wraps? It means he was kept hidden. Nobody knew about Laszlong before. Okay, nobody knew that there was such a good long jumper in Hitler's team. So, evidently hoping to win the jump with him. I guessed that if Long won, it would add some new support to the Nazis' Aryan superiority theory. Questions will come from this. What is Aryan superiority theory? Nazis, that is the team of Hitler, had a belief in the theory of racial hierarchy. What is that? They believed that they are best. The Nazis believed, the people of Germany believed that they were best. The Nazis had an idea that Germans were a part of the Aryan master race. They believed that other people are inferior, only the Germans were a part of Aryan, were the Aryans, and they were a superior class, and they were better than the others. So if Laszlong won, then what would happen? Then everybody will start believing in this, that yes, look at this. Now Hitler's players are winning. So everybody will keep on believing in this Nazi's Aryan superiority theory. And Jesse Owens wanted to prove this wrong. Jesse Owens wanted to show that although he is a Negro, he is black skinned, he can surely win the race. After all, I am a Negro. So he's a Native American, dark-skinned. Jesse Owens feels that although I'm dark-skinned and I'm Native American, I'm not German, and they think that I am inferior, I will prove that no, I'm not inferior. So a little hot under the collar about Hitler's ways, I determined to go out there and really show Dörfer. What is Dörfer? It is the political title given to Hitler. So Jesse Owens wanted to prove Hitler that Hitler's ideas, Hitler's beliefs about this Aryan supremacy, this is wrong. And even a Negro can win. Even a Negro can be better than the Germans. And his master race, who was superior and who wasn't. So he wanted to prove Hitler that, see, I have practiced and that is why I have won. So he was a bit angry. Now he comes for the trials. An angry athlete is an athlete who will make mistakes. So we always have to keep in mind that whenever we are going to do something, we have to keep our head cool. Whatever problem it might be, maybe you're facing a lot of problem, even then you have to keep your mind cool so that you can think better. Whenever you are frustrated, whenever you are worried, whenever you are angry, sad, when you have too much of emotion, you stop thinking properly. Your head stops working properly, and then what does happen? You make mistakes. So this happened, as any coach will tell you. So as I was very angry with the Aryans, with the German people, I started making mistakes. I was no exception. I made mistakes. On the first of my three qualifying jumps, I leaped from several inches beyond the takeoff board for a foul. So I leaped from several inches beyond the takeoff board. What happened is I made a lot of mistakes. I'll show you what happens. This is the place from where the participant have to jump. Okay, participants have to jump from this spot. Now, if he crosses this spot while jumping, he has to run from here, somewhere from here, and he has to come. If he crosses before jumping, if he crosses this line before jumping, then he has fouled. What do you mean by foul? He has broken the rules of the game and therefore he is disqualified. Okay, so three chances are given. If in all the three cases he moves away, or if he crosses this line, then what will happen? He will be disqualified from the Olympic Games in long jump. So now what happens? Because this person is too much worried and too much angry about the ideas of Hitler, he constantly goes on fouling. That is, he constantly crosses this line, and it happens two times. There are three chances given to the players, and what happens is both the times he has crossed the line before jumping. So he is disqualified. There is only one chance left. Did I come? Now he is very angry with himself. Did I come 3000 miles for this? So I have come from such a far away place. I have come from so far, I thought bitterly, to foul out of the trials and make a fool of myself. Now what am I showing? Everybody is seeing. Everybody from the different parts of the world are seeing this game. And all of them are seeing what? That I'm constantly fouling. Okay. All the players had and my people of the Native Americans, they were also had a lot of high thinking about me, and everything is being broken. Why? Because I am constantly fouling. I cannot even qualify for the trials. I will not be able to go to the finals also. Now, walking a few yards from the pit, I kicked disgustedly at the dart. So I was very disgusted. I was frustrated that what is wrong with me? What is happening to me? Suddenly I felt a hand on my shoulder. I turned to look into the friendly blue eyes of the tall German broad jumper. So when I looked back, there was somebody who had kept a hand on my shoulder. And when I looked back, I found it was that person, that Lars Long, who was jumping very well, who was my competitor. He had easily qualified. He was jumping very well. He he was a very good participant, so he had already qualified in the first attempt only. Three chances are given. In the first attempt itself, he has scored well and he has qualified. But I have not yet qualified. How many chances are left? Only one. He offered me a firm handshake. So he shook my hands. Jesse Owens, I am Luz Long. I don't think we have met. He spoke English well, though with a German twist to it. So he was a German, he was speaking in English. Glad to meet you, I said. Then trying to hide my nervousness, I added, how are you? I'm fine. The question is, so now Luz Long asks him, how are you? What do you mean, I asked. Something must be eating you. What does this word mean, eating you? It means that something must be bothering you. Proud of the way foreigners are when they have mastered a bit of American slang. You should be able to qualify with your eyes closed. So Luz Long said that you are so good in long jump or you are so good in broad jump, then you should have qualified in the first attempt. Something must be wrong with you. Okay, something must be disturbing you. What is it? Believe me, I know it. I told him, and it felt good to say that to someone. Obviously, Jesse Owens knows it, that something must be wrong with him. He should have qualified. For the next few minutes, we talked together. I didn't tell Long what was eating or what was bothering me, but he seemed to understand my anger. Luz Long was a good human being. Okay, he was not just a participant. He was a good human being. He understood the problem with Jesse Owens and he tried to solve it. And he took pains to reassure me. Although he had been schooled in the Nazi youth movement, he didn't believe in the Aryan supremacy business any more than I did. So this person, Luz Long, was schooled or was a part of this Nazi youth movement. He was a part of the Nazi or the Germans of the Hitler's group of people that were under Hitler. But his ways or his ideas were not the same as Hitler's. He did not believe in this Aryan supremacy business. He did not believe that Germans were the superior most race, were the most superior race. It was nothing like that he believed in. He obviously felt that if somebody has performed well, whatever might be his race, he might be an Indian, he might be an American, he might be from somewhere else, but if he has practiced well, he can obviously win. There is nothing like this that only Germans who have a, you know, very high quality and they are superior, only they can win. It is not like that, which he believed in. So we laughed over the fact that he really looked the part though. An inch taller than I, he had a lean, muscular frame, clear blue eyes, blonde hair, and strikingly handsome chiseled face. Chisel means it was very well shaped and handsome. He had a very beautiful face, blue eyes, he had blonde hair, and he was very good looking. He was tall also. Finally, seeing that I had calmed down somewhat, although the Negro, that is Jesse Owens, felt that this Luz Long must be very proud of himself because he was beautiful or proud because he could jump well, he could qualify in the first attempt, he was not that. Luz Long was quite different. Finally, seeing that I had calmed down somewhat, I pointed to the takeoff board. What is the takeoff board? Takeoff board is this one. Okay. So he showed me. He took me to this place. Now he gives me an idea. What is that idea? Look, he said, why don't you draw a line a few inches in the back of the board? So what was the idea that Jesse Owens gave to Luz Long? He said that you can do one thing. You can draw a line a few inches back of the board. That is, if this one is the line which you should not cross, then you draw a line before that, so that anyhow, if you target this spot, that no, I'm not going to cross this spot, then obviously you will qualify, because obviously even if you cross this line and jump from here, then also you will qualify, because this is actually the line you should not cross. So if you draw a line few inches before that, if you target this one, your qualifying spot, then obviously you will never cross this line. So then, although you will not be able to be the best one in the trials, maybe if you start from here and if you do not start from here, here also there will be, you will not be that good in qualifying for the trials. You may not be the first one or the best one in the qualifying rounds. But at least you will be able to qualify for the finals and then you can obviously do well there. Look, he said, Okay, this one is done. You will sure not to foul and you certainly ought to jump far enough to qualify. What does it matter if you are not the first in the trial? So, if you start a little bit back, if you target your qualifying line a little bit back, you can, or you will surely not foul and then you will qualify. And then at least you will be given to participate in the finals. And then when you are given to participate in the finals, you do your best. Tomorrow is what counts. So tomorrow is the final. So tomorrow is the day when you need to score best. So today, at least you try so that you can qualify for the trials. Suddenly, all the tension seemed to ebb away. That is, all my tension started to go away of my body as the truth of what he said hit me. So I have understood that, okay, this man, Luzlong, is obviously trying to help me. He was not just a competitor. He was also a friend. If somebody competes you, it is not that he cannot be your friend. He can surely help you and he can surely be your friend. You can help each other. And then you both of you try to do your best, give your best, compete with yourself. And then whoever can score better, he wins. There is nothing to be an enemy of the other person because he is competing with you. Confidently, I drew a line a full foot in back of the board and proceeded to jump from there. I qualified with almost a foot to spare. So I qualified with a foot to almost a foot to spare. Now finally, taking the idea of Luzlong, he finally qualified in the last trial. That night, I walked over to Luzlong's room in the Olympic Village to thank him. So it was because of Luzlong that I qualified. So I was very happy. I went to his room to thank him. I knew that if it hadn't been for him, I probably would not be jumping in the finals the following day. We sat in his quarters, that is, we sat in his room and we gossiped. We talked for 2 hours about track and field, ourselves, the world situation, a dozen other things. So we gossiped a lot. We have become friends. When I finally got up to leave, we both knew that a real friendship has been formed. Luz would go out to the field the next day trying to beat me if he could. So obviously, tomorrow is going to be the finals. Both of us will go to the field and compete each other. We will be competitors, but we will also know that we are best of friends. But I knew that he wanted to do my best, even if that meant my winning. Luzlong will also do his best and Jesse Owens will also do his best. So it will be a competition with his own self. Now the person who will break his own records will win. As it turned out, Luz broke his own past record. So Luz broke his own past record. Whatever Luz had scored, he scored better than that. Okay. In doing so, he pushed me to my peak performance. Peak performance means because Luz did so well, I also tried to do better. So what happened is, I remembered that at the instant I landed from my final jump, the one which set the Olympic record of 26 feet 5 and 5 by 16 inches. So this was the world Olympic record in long jump. So he was at my side congratulating me. So what do you understand from this? That Luzlong did his best. But in the game, in the Olympic game, who won? Jesse Owens won with a record of 26 feet 5 by 16 inches. So although Luzlong could not win the gold medal, he came to congratulate me. Okay, so this is Jesse Owens. It's a true story. So you get the true pictures from Google. You can Google it and watch it, obviously. There are videos also. So this is Jesse Owens who was jumping. This was the last jump in the 1936 Olympic Games. So despite the fact that Hitler glared, Hitler was very angry because his player, such a good player, could not win. At us from the stands, not 100 yards away, although Hitler was very angry with Luzlong, Luz shook my hand hard and it wasn't a fake smile with a broken heart sort of grip either. So when he was shaking his hands with me, I knew it very well that although Luzlong did not win, he was very happy that I won. Last, you can melt down all the gold medals and cups I have. Obviously, I have won a number of medals and everything. But what is more important? Do you think that these medals were more important? No, because those medals can be of gold. But what was more important is the 24 carat friendship. What is 24 carat? 24 carat is the purest gold content. There was nothing mixed with that gold. It was a completely pure form of friendship, just like pure gold. So more important to me was the friendship that I made with Luzlong and not the gold medals that I won. I felt that Luzlong at the moment, I realized then too that Luz was the epitome. Epitome means that he was a perfect example of what? Of what Pierre de Coubertin, who was this person? He was the founder of the modern Olympic Games. He was the founder of the Olympic Games. He had an idea about the games. What should be games? What is a game? The important thing in the Olympic Games is not winning but taking part. This is very, very important, this one. We have to remember that game is made, why? It is not about winning. It is so that you can take part, so that you can perform your best and not fight with the other person or not try to, you know, start hating the other person because he won. We have to understand that we need to do our best and then it is all destiny. If you win, then you win. If you cannot win, then you try harder the next time. That is all about the Olympic Games. The essential thing is life. In life is not conquering, that is, victory is not always important. What is important is fighting well. You do your best. You give your best. You practice well. You work hard. And you try to do your best in the finals. But then, after that, it is all your destiny. There can be a better performer. There can be somebody who practiced harder than you. And then you know that who is going to be the winner. Then you see him, learn from him, try to do better in the next time. That is all about games. So from here, this is the last image that I will like to show you. This is Jesse Owens and this one is Luzlong and this one is Jesse Owens. This shows the friendship between them which lasted long. Okay, this is all. This is what is important in the end, isn't it? So the themes of the story can be true spirit of sportsmanship. What is sportsmanship? It is an aspiration that a sport will be enjoyed, that you will enjoy the sport just for the sport. And there should be fairness, ethics, respect for the other competitors and a sense of fellowship, friendship with the competitors. So the German athlete Luzlong showed the true spirit of sportsmanship by trying to help Jesse Owens. If Luzlong had not helped Jesse Owens, then he surely would be disqualified in the trials only, isn't it? So this shows his true sportsmanship. And last one, it also, another theme in the story is true friendship. Jesse Owens, through his short autobiographical account, shows the true and honest friendship formed between him and the German athlete, that is Luzlong. That was most important to him, even more important than the medals that he had won. When Luzlong saw Owens making fouls, he acted as a true guide and friend. It could have happened that Jesse Owens could have fouled and just went out of the game. Then it would be easier for Luzlong to win. Even then, he wanted a fair fight. Luzlong came and helped Jesse Owens. Why? So that both the participants could fight well and then the better could win. So in the finals, Jesse Owens won gold medals, but the friendship he formed with Luzlong was his greatest Olympic prize. Nothing could be better than that. So that is all about the story and the theme and everything I've already discussed. Meanings I've given. Questions I will give in the next class.